Time travel can be complicated and complicating, so let's ignore all the paradoxical stuff and talk about a few simple ways that you can time travel without leaving your home. First, do nothing. You're already traveling through time. I mean, here you are, 15 seconds into the future since the start of this video. Easy, right? The point is, we're all always traveling forwards through time. But that's boring time travel. What's interesting is time travel relative to other people. To do that, start walking, and you'll travel through time relative to someone standing still. We've known for over a century that time and space are really just two components of a single space-time, and the faster you move, the slower time will pass for you. If you take a walk around the block, you'll be 3 femtoseconds younger than your friend who stayed home. Except, in order to walk around the block, you had to stand up. You're now further from the Earth, and so gravity is a tiny bit weaker for you, which means you're traveling through time relative to your friend who's sitting down. That's right, more gravity makes time slow down too. If you stand up for a minute, your feet will age 10 femtoseconds less than your head. On the other hand, GPS satellites high in orbit experience less of Earth's gravity and thus travel noticeably faster through time than we do, which is why their clocks are calibrated to run slow. But maybe you want to time travel more than a few femtoseconds. Get ready for your head to start spinning. I mean, the universe. Because if the whole universe were spinning really fast, general relativity predicts there would be time loops all over the place. Moving along one of these loops, you'd always feel like you were moving forwards in time, but overall you'd loop around and travel back to a time and place in your own past. It's a little like how you can keep moving forwards on the Earth, but Earth's curvature brings you back to where you started. Unfortunately, our universe isn't spinning. Maybe it would be easier to build an infinitely long, super dense spinning cylinder, which would also curve space-time enough to create a time loop. The problem, of course, is how do you build something that's infinite in size? Maybe you could just make it really, really big? No. If you tried to squeeze this time machine into finite space, you'd need negative energy, something nobody knows how to create, to make it work. Otherwise, you'd end up with a black hole. Wait, but what if instead of a black hole, we built a wormhole? Wormholes are hypothetical, but not physically impossible, bridges through space-time. Shortcuts that can instantaneously connect two different places and times in our universe. If you had a wormhole, you might be able to use it to travel into the past or the future. The problem is that no one knows how to build a wormhole, or once you've built it, how to keep it from collapsing. As Sean Carroll has eloquently written, keeping wormholes open requires a form of negative energies. Nobody knows how to make negative energies, although they occasionally slap the name exotic matter on the concept and pretend it might exist. Well, that's too bad, but as a consolation, welcome to the future. Almost 3 minutes have passed since the beginning of this video, and we now have personal jetpacks. I'd like to thank Atish Bhatia of the blog Empirical Zeal for helping me write this video, and also Volkswagen, who want you to know they're doing their best to slow down time by offering no-charge scheduled maintenance for the first 2 years or 24,000 miles on every new car. Time slows down when you're moving, so driving 24,000 miles will keep your car 5 nanoseconds younger.